Kalau kita bicara tentang talk about our civilization, talk about our culture, the future culture, future humanity. Sometimes we have a main concept called growth. Growth is everything in line of life. Growth. So, what is the antithesis of growth? I call it tazkiyah from Islamic terms, Islamic times. Tazkiyah. Kita lihat dominasi peradaban yang sekarang dan dominasi dunia sekarang ada di 4.0. Bahkan revolusi industri ini sebenarnya hanyalah bagian dari evolusi, part of evolution from Industrial Revolution 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, and now 4.0. What is the main value for 4.0? We just look at the technical problem, not the deep problem in 4.0. We just look at why IoT is important. Internet of Things is important. Big data is important for us. Grab is important for us because for Grab we can choose where we go. Yeah, just that. But we don't have anything else. My world is, our world is just, now industry is smart. To create smart factories, smart homes, smart buildings, smart grid, smart mobility, smart logistics, business web, social web, internet, etc. But we don't know about what the deep meaning of 4.0 is. It clearly second point is SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals 2030. Part of education 2030, education 2030 is about cognitive, about rational, about how to ensure inclusive and equitable. Yang sana aman ya? Ya? Anunya rusak. Oh, anunya rusak. Anu this
thing. Abstract.
Anu.
Explain.
Ya?
Explain.
Ya. So. Here. Don't move. Okay. Don't move. Okay. First, 4.0 industrial revolution is just technical. We think about technical 4.0. Sustainable development goals. We look at the technical tool. It's good, it's clear. It's about our future is about quality of life, etc. In Indonesia juga sama. 4.0 jump the blending 4.0 blending with SDGs, and then our ministry decide cognitive long life education and etc. We do nothing. Indonesia is like another country. We do nothing about what is the meaning, deep meaning, or the symbol of 4.0 or SDGs. No. Just compile, create, and we are the part of universe. Just that. So, is it enough to understand reality like that? If we want to keep kita menggali lebih dalam, apa? You don't move from here. Just because this issue is beyond this technology. Okay, the three important transition of 21st century. We have kita punya masalah besar sebenarnya kalau kita lihat 4.0 dan SDGs. Apa? Geopolitik global yang jadi tensi politik ekonomi, geopolitik ekonomi kita itu dahsyat sekali. We have a war between East and West, between New Silk Road and Grand Pacific. Grand Pacific is Western US, Europe, Israel, Australia, Japan, and Arab Saudi too. If you want to look at clearly, Indonesia in between swing of civilization between Grand Pacific and Grand Pacific and New Silk Road. We have America, Union Europa, Japan, Japan, Israel, Uni Emirat Arab. But we have mungkin sebelah kanan saja ya. If you want to, you can sit there.
My grace.
Yeah.
My grace.
Please. Please, migration to. Okay. We have swing of civilization between Grand Pacific and New Zealand. Indonesia still in swing. Like Surya, like that. Swing. We have Islamic countries is friend of Union Europa and America. But look, Iran and Turkey in Music Road, Asia, India, to Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, Nepal. So America, I think, is plus. Dan Indonesia berada di ayunan itu. Makanya kalau mau ribut our election between Jokowi or Prabowo, just like that. The Prabowo is in there, Jokowi is there. But we have no idea about our like. Chopra Aminoto said, self-based, self-sufficient, our kemandirian tak ada. Soon. Why is that? Why? Because this is the first problem, the geopolitical economic tension of civil. And then, number two, the weakening the carrying capacity of England. Our environmental is going down. Our greedy is about our mind. Seperti ulat itu. Apa? Ulat itu bahasa Inggrisnya apa? Warm, like warm, like warm, before become butterfly. Yeah, greedy. And number two, number three, improvement in science, technology, acceleration. All three are triggered by the concept of growth. In all lines of life as the consequence of Darwinism, evolution. Tiga hal besar yang mendesain peradaban kita ini adalah konsep pertumbuhan. Dari mana? Konsekuensi dari evolusi Darwinisme. Sehingga inilah yang kemudian membuat turbulensi. All three have an impact on the increasingly uneasy existence of culture and humanitarian religiosity and the year 2024 is the culmination of turbulence in the transition because energy and food is the problem of us. When 8 billion, eight billion. Demographic in 2024
when our earth is not enough. And then growth and industrial revolution, growth values and 4.0 menjadi satu. Muncullah yang disebut dengan Homo Deus itu, manusia Tuhan. Kitalah Tuhan itu, we are the God. There is no God, but we are. Not like Moses. Musa ketika bertemu Fir'aun, hanya Fir'aun yang berani mengatakan, I'm the God. Tapi, right now, we are the Fir'aun. We are the Paraos. We are the God. So, what, apa yang menjadi ciri dari, Harari mengatakan, ciri dari cara bekerjanya menjadi becoming God. Kita harus menjadi the Western, the educated, industrialist, rich and democratic. Sejalan. Coba, lihat. Rukul. Apa? Apa growth itu memang penting bagi negara kita, bagi Indonesia, bagi seluruh negara? In all the countries, growth is just like that. Indonesia dengan konsep pertumbuhannya, dia akan tetap saja menjadi desain bagi hutan. It's the problem of growth. Indonesia tidak akan pernah jadi negara yang besar karena kita menggunakan we choose the growth concept. So bagaimana cara untuk mempertahankan growth itu? Bagaimana? War is the key. So Surya, India, Indonesia, perang di mana-mana. Who is the behind of war? Who? It's called multinational companies. Because they control land, energy, and food. War. Growth and war. This the plan. Next. Kita kadang-kadang bangga, enggak, growth itu penting. Pertumbuhan, growth is important for us. Because 2030, Indonesia become a biggest nation. First, I believe that, but when I look at the deep of the reports from MGI, Indonesia just market opportunity, just members of consuming class, skilled workers, just like that. Is it our dreams? We are the market of Samsung. We are the market of what else? Oppo. We are the market of
Xiaomi.
We are Huawei. We are the market of Toyota. We
You are the market of everything. Just market. That's the point of clothing. Next. Why growth is always up, up, and up, and up, and up? Because evolution should be up, up, up.
So, baru saja, evolution, coba lihat.
Ini, saya coba untuk mendesain peradaban itu dalam 4 fase. So, tapi, ada satu kata kunci. When science and technology higher, spirituality becomes lower. Next. It's okay. Next. Taylor pernah mengatakan dalam sebuah bukunya, di sebuah bukunya, bahwa yang namanya teknologi always growth, but human adaptability is more slow. Can we change another thinking? Next. If we design like that, Mula Warman, my name. If religiosity right now is going down, and ketundukan makin. Next. Kalau itu ditemukan gimana? Kalau itu ditemukan, next, kalau itu di crossing grab, we have confused human area between human obedience and human adaptability. Have no idea about religiosity. Kita hanya sibuk about technology. Kita tidak pernah sibuk dengan religiosity. When the conflict is started right now. Next. Jadi, we just look at fact and context. The creativity we build is pseudo creativity. We become stuff of civilization, not true civilization creators. Why? Because we have no idea. Next. Because karena kita selalu saja ada di antara ini, kita tidak pernah berpikir menyeluruh bahwa ada agama-agama lama dengan morality and deity revolution. Kita hanya percaya science and technology revolution with data religion algorithm. So, who is the winner? Next. So, what is the group in Islam? In Islam, good similar with riba. Usually, riba sama dengan interest. Selalu saja interest. Bahkan dalam surat Al-Baqarah itu dikatakan, kalau kamu selalu berpikir riba, kamu itu kayak orang yang terhuyung-huyung, mabuk terhuyung-huyung. Ternyata, Hogan Dix
dari Belanda
juga mengatakan begitu,
bahwa yang namanya manusia itu kalau sudah terlalu berpikir tentang pertumbuhan, like a giant stagger force to keep running so as not to fall, and when they run, they destroy forest, fauna, and the surface of the earth, as well as water and land, including the countryside, the old city center, as well as the established social structure where people live. This is Broken Beach said, this is Al-Quran said. Kita itu kayak raksasa yang sedang mabuk, karena semua yang kita pikirkan adalah kepentingan. Riba itu not just transaction about money and plus, not just like that. Most acute riba adalah interest. That's good definition from Quran. Kadang-kadang, Pak Nabi, kita memahami riba itu Islamic banking. Ya, yeah. But I think Islamic banking is riba too. Because Islamic banking don't know in deep about most acute issue. Thanks. So, how does Islam offer an alternative? Like what? This is crude. Greedy. Everything is it. So, if you don't want like ulat, kamu, jika kamu tidak ingin jadi ulat, segeralah hijrah. Sikir yang banyak, puasa yang banyak, kurangi makan nasi, tengah tengah malam, ketemulah sama Tuhan. That's riba, because you are kalianlah manusia-manusia penghancur dunia. Karena apa? Karena kalianlah yang suka makan nasi dan menghabisi dunia ini.